Insects live in practically every area on the earth, and that's going to be his topic for tonight. And I'd like to introduce you to you now, a man that's here to bug you, Karl Priest.
If you were a flea and could if you could jump in proportion to your size to a flea, you could jump over those three large buildings. There's an insect called a frog hopper that can jump higher than a flea. It would be equal to a man jumping over a 70-story skyscraper. That little frog hopper, when it jumps, it's just a little tiny thing that gets on a plant, experiences 400 G's. An experienced fighter pilot passes out at 7 G's. Dragonflies. This is a baby dragonfly, a nymph of a dragonfly. They're aquatic. They live underwater. They're well suited to that habitat. This one's catching a fish for a little fish sandwich dinner. Some dragonflies will live underwater 1 to 4 years. They have internal gills for a jet propulsion system that propels them around the bottom surface of a stream. They have a mouth part that's like a fork and a spoon that unfolds at lightning speed. Here's a picture of the mouth part. Lightning speed to catch their prey. They get along just fine there. But God, with his amazing sense of humor, his amazing creativity, his artistic ability, his engineering genius, designed that dragonfly to crawl up out of there at a certain time and shed that skin and come out with those wonderful wings. Now, dragonflies are harmless. They don't bite. In North Carolina, they're called skeeter hawks. They catch a lot of mosquitoes, and they're wonderful to watch fly, and scientists have noticed that. There's a stop action of a dragonfly in flight with four wings beating and bending. Here's another quote. A scientist says, they're a marvel of engineering. You don't get engineering out of a brainless thing called evolution. Their wings beat 50 times per second, and that's slow in the insect world. As they beat, they twist and bend. Dragonflies can fly 35 miles an hour. They can make a 180-degree turn. They can hover like a helicopter. They can reverse. They can fly upside down. Their aerodynamics is astounding. They coordinate each wing's stroke and angle. Here's another quote. They're very precisely engineered flying instruments. Now, boys and girls, we're about ready to have some fun. You've been patient. I'm not going to talk much longer. God said, insects, the word insect is not in the Bible because it wasn't invented when the Bible was written. Insects are included in the creeping things. And God said, when he created everything that creepeth upon the earth, that it was good. You know, there's limits to what we can conceive. Our imaginations fail us in understanding God. So we use human traits to refer to him. A human mind can never completely conceive how great God is. And this song that's going to be playing as we look at some slides now has the words, your works, Lord, are awesome. You can start the music, brother. Your power is great. Great are your works, Lord. Kids, you're allowed to laugh and have a little bit of fun. There's a leaf insect. The Bible says there is no searching, there's understanding. Show God has unsurpassed genius. He's a magnificent artist, a splendid sense of humor, and he calls us friends. Go ahead, brother. I saved the best ones for this section. Hold on, kids. We're going to have some fun. Before time began, God decided to share his creation with us. I believe God is delighted in all he has done. Ready for the grand finale now. I believe God wanted you to laugh. Don't play it yet. God wanted you to laugh at those things. He had fun when he did it. God has a great sense of humor. Our ancestor Adam was specifically formed, and then God breathed in the breath of life into Adam and made him a living soul. Humans were set apart from and given dominion over the animals. We're made in the image of God. We can reason, create, and recognize evil. Most importantly, we were created to have fellowship with our Creator. Insects don't allow us to be comfortable in this world. They give us a lot of enjoyment and a lot of benefits, but they don't allow us to get comfortable because certain ones of them really can be a problem. They remind us that we're living in a sin-cursed world. We're going to end up with butterflies and moths. I want to talk a little bit about the technical things, then we're going to end up with a grand finale. Butterflies use their wings for flight and camouflage, but also thermoregulation and signaling. Other butterflies can see them up to a half a mile away. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. That's Jesus Christ. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came into his own, and his own received him not. He came to us and we didn't receive him. Some of us have, thanks to his grace. And someday, folks, we're going to fly away. We don't know where heaven is. You can say it's up there if you want to, but you don't know how to get there. But God's going to get us there, just like that monarch gets to that tree. You can start the music, brother. And after this, I'm finished. And if you're from a church that likes to say amen, this is the time to do it. If you want to applaud at the end, I'm going to applaud the Lord. Join me in applause. We're going to look at the artistic beauty of God. And someday we're going to behold this Creator face to face.